The following program is presented by Pro Sound and Video.
Music videos that'll get you grooving, original entertainment pieces that'll have you laughing your socks off, feature stories on the best and brightest of McFatter,
and some feature stories from guest schools that we're proud to have here on this episode of Broward Teen News.
Welcome to this episode of Broward Teen News. I'm Mariah.
And I'm Max.
And we're television production students here at McFatter Technical High School.
We've got a great show for you today. Christopher Columbus High and John A. Ferguson High have also prepared some content to be aired in this episode. But before we get to that, let's check out some music videos from right here at McFatter.
First, we have a video that I co-produced with my classmates Jada Gomez, Emily Badgerdine, and Catherine Manorang. We recreated the music video for the song Generation Y by Conan Gray.
Suburban moms, I called a friend. Let's meet at 10, go wherever we want, 'cause no one cares if we're gone. This town don't got much to do, and you and I haven't got much to lose. So do you wanna rock in your room like we always do? Talk about how fast we grew. We are the helpless, selfish, one of a kind. Millennium kids that all wanna die. Walking in the street with no light inside our eyes. We are the worthless, cursed with too much time. We get into trouble and lose our minds. Something that I've heard a million times in my life. Generation Y.
Parents think we're fast asleep. Just move to the moon. This town don't got much to do, and you and I haven't got much to lose. So do you wanna leave everyone in this place for good?
'Cause we are the helpless, selfish, one of a kind. Millennium kids, I wanna die. Walking in the street with no light inside our eyes. We are the worthless, cursed with too much time.
Selfish, one of a kind. Millennium kids that all wanna die. Walking in the street with no light inside our eyes.
We are the worthless, cursed with too much time. We get into trouble and lose our minds. Something that I've heard a million times in my life.
Ago, I interviewed Jackie Hunt, a fellow McFatter senior. Jackie and her family own and care for a lot of animals, and I mean a lot of animals. She's practically living in a petting zoo. I'll let you see it for yourself.
Lots of people have pets. You might have a dog or a cat, maybe even a bird. But McFatter Technical High School student Jackie Hunt is much more than your average pet owner. Jackie and her family have a reputation for taking in exotic animals in need of a home.
We have Clyde. We got him from a friend of my grandmother's. He passed away, and so he needed someone to take care of it, so we adopted him. Bubs, our pig, we got her from two ladies who are gonna bring her back to the pet store. And my grandma seemed to notice that they had a pig in their arms and went into this whole backstory of how she had a farm and pigs of her own, and they just handed her off to her. And we got Pippi, our dog, our little poodle, from a lady who couldn't keep a dog in her apartment anymore. So now we have her. And grandma has a whole bunch of bunnies from literally, I don't know where. I think it's just generations and generations of bunnies that she had in New Hampshire. She brought them down on a bus in her jacket, and she just came down here and bred them, and now we have a ton of them.
Jackie's love for animals is nothing new in the Hunt family.
We lived on a farm my whole life. Pigs, chickens, sheep.
Her parents believe that growing up with so many animals has been formative for Jackie and her sister.
It gives them a little responsibility. There's nothing wrong about animals. You know, they just give, give, give. So.
Despite how much of her life has been dedicated to her animals, the novelty has not worn off.
They all have their little personalities. They're their own little people. And I can talk to them. They always look like they know what you're saying, especially Pippi. Pippi's got some expressions on her. She'll just give you this look and you can't help but smile. The little noises that they make or faces that they give you, it just makes me happier. It brightens my day.
If there's one thing we can learn from Jackie and her nurturing philosophy, it's that animals need love just like anyone else. Reporting for The Surge, I'm Mariah.
Here at McFatter, we love seeing the works of our peers across South Florida. It sets off this competitive fire within us, making us work harder and create better projects.
But the students from our first guest school on this episode, Christopher Columbus High, might be the best we've seen yet. Besides ourselves, of course. They made these amazing news packages in only 24 hours.
Here's a story from reporter Marcus Caligari that'll leave you squeaky clean.
The Bubble Run is a 5K that incorporates bubbles for a unique running experience. It's been ran by over 1.2 million runners worldwide, and today South Florida residents can experience its miles of smiles.
So the Bubble Run is basically a 5K, and you run in a track. There's a lot of bubbles, so it's a lot of fun, and it's basically a fun run, which means that you can come with your family and anybody can truly run it. There's people in strollers, so it's just open to everybody.
So the Bubble Run for me is just, it's an event that I can really, really be a kid again, basically, and I can just have fun with my family, and you know, I definitely think that it promotes a healthy well-being and being with family and incorporating, you know, both fitness and family fun.
Not only is the Bubble Run packed with family fun, it also benefits the community.
So our charity that we have that we're partnered with is One Wish. They're based out of Phoenix. So they do a lot of work with the Children's Hospital. So every time a participant signs up, they do a dollar donation that goes directly to that charity. And then they go out a couple times a year, and then they give out, you know, big checks out to the hospitals.
As foam covered participants like myself leave the event, the Bubble Run will continue its tour around the country, leaving lots of fun in its wake. Reporting for CCN Live, I'm Marcus Caligari.
Arbetter's world-famous chili dogs in Westchester. Established in 1959, this family-run stable restaurant in Miami has a reputation. You know what? I'll just let CCNN Live reporter Alexander Samulin fill you in on the rest.
Nestled in the heart of Westchester is Arbetter's Hot Dogs, a family-owned restaurant that has been a city staple for 60 years.
Then we moved here, my parents found this place. They put every last penny, they sunk into it. They opened it up, and I think it was a lot of karma because we had treated people well over the years and they really loved our food. And all the people we knew, which were literally a lot of people, when you add it all up. And everybody started coming in and they loved the place.
But what makes Arbetter's so special is the customers that eat here.
Well, I first started coming into Arbetter's when it opened in 1959. It was located on Flagler Street. It's just people come from all over the world And when they come back into Miami, where are you going? I want to go to Arbetter's.
But with Nathan's Hot Dogs opening down the street, this city staple has a new competitor.
Look, since Nathan's has come, I've spent over $300,000 on this place to redo things, get it just how I want it. I want to do my best to make everyone love Arbetter's.
Corn dogs, cheese fries, onions.
Arbetter's is a staple of the community. As I said to you, everybody, all types of life come here. The rich, the poor, it's enjoyable. You come here and you get back to life. This is a great place. This is the best hot dog. The quality of these hot dogs are unbelievable.
And whether it's the chili cheese fries or the hot dogs that draws its many customers, Arbetter's enthusiasts will continue to enjoy this city staple for years to come.
Chili cheese fry?
Thank you, man. For CCNN Live, I'm Alexander Somayan reporting.
This month, we also reached out to John A. Ferguson High to see what they've been working on. Here's student reporter Edward Franco, who got to experience Media Row for this year's Super Bowl. Let's check it out.
On the pre-days of Super Bowl 54, all eyes are focused here on South Florida. Media Row at the Miami Beach Convention Center is where all the special event coverage comes from. Journalists from around the world are here all week to tell every side of the story.
A Super Bowl for us is all about the stories, right? It's about not just the game. The game on Sunday is important, but we have to fill 7 days of stories. So as a journalist, we just work and telling stories. So every day it's find a new story. You know, what's the angle today? Who's speaking today? What can we share to the viewer that's interesting about Super Bowl week as we get them ready for the game? You do learn from other journalists and what the things that they do in their specific jobs and their markets. So it's a cool experience for us. Again, you meet journalists from literally all over the world during this week.
Not only are there journalists from all over the world, but there's also visitors from all corners of the globe. People come to Miami to experience all what the NFL's Super Bowl 54 has to offer.
The cool thing is everybody congregates, everybody gets together and gets to enjoy our city, and they come and they just enjoy it. You know, they have fun. People are here to have a good time, you know. Most of the people that are in town aren't going to the game. I mean, what do you have, 70,000 people go to the game? There are hundreds of thousands of people, millions of people in town visiting. So a lot of people just want to come to experience Super Bowl week. You know, and whether you're a Chiefs fan, a 49ers fan, or a fan of another team, it makes for a really fun week and a cool experience.
There you have it. Here at Super Bowl 54's Media Row, everyone is nonstop and there's always something going on. It's definitely the heart of the NFL pregame coverage. I'm Edward Franco reporting from Miami Beach, FBN News.
Often, certain parts of having a healthy hygiene are met with stigma for men. But Catherine Mannering is here to teach us boys how to take care of our skin.
Athlete is hard. Waking up really early to grind it out in practice, then quote the Bible verse of the day and follow all that up with class. Now imagine doing all of that two separate times for two separate sports.
Vernest Johnson IV is an athlete.
He's been one for a very long time.
I've played sports for as long as I can remember. It's honestly in my blood at this point.
You can't just do academics. You also needed to do physical things because it helps you with concentration, focus.
Bad thing about crazy feet? That thing hurt, homie.
Vernest now plays lacrosse and football.
Playing lacrosse and football at the same time is busy. The finesse and stamina from lacrosse and then the physicality and grit from playing football.
Ironically, I don't think he cared for football when he was younger. So it was a surprise to me when going into high school, he said he wanted to play football.
But he hasn't always played multiple sports.
Yeah, my mom did push me to branch out. I actually remember coming home after trying out lacrosse.
Remember when you said if they have a sport at the school that I never did before to go ahead and try it, I might like it? Well, I'm doing lacrosse, and I do like it. It's a lot of fun. And I was like, I did resist the urge to say I told you so. Because so many times, especially if you're Black, you tend to navigate to those things that society dictates you should know how to do. I didn't want him to be stereotypical. He likes to study things that he likes. The technique, once they showed him, he was a pretty quick study. I like what he's accomplished so far. It is an anomaly at the moment.
I think it's because I play two sports, that's why I'm here. It makes me a better athlete and keeps me busy.
Tyler, the Creator, is the only artist I know that can, within a single album, create an intricate and amusing character that features the greatest bob cut wig ever to grace anyone's eyeballs and poppy but fashionable suits. This is our best attempt to capture the magic that is Igor in Gelato.
What's the dealio? Ain't gonna lie, I'm feeling yo. You got me on tippy toe, so who's I love, who's Elio? It don't matter. Negative gon' say this don't add up, but fuck they math up. We subtract them. Ayo, tell me what's the problem? I just pop models. Boys or girls these days, shit, it don't matter. We could fuck Sunday cause I don't read Bibles, but I'm faithful to this money and it's selling goggles. I don't pop bottles, I just cop automobiles, full throttle, new engine can't follow. Get a jet to Lake Como, we could try some new gelato. Shorty, I'm for real, like my role model.
Sensational.
Shawty, I listen. Unlike my father, I could give you attention. You won't feel empty like pocket that lint in. So pack a few bags, I got space in my mentions. Plural. Hurry with decision, cause I'm looking for a parrot and you looking like a pigeon. Better that so raven and get another vision if you wanna be my newest addition like Vivid. Whoa.
Yeah, yeah. I got a plan, cause you're more than that.
No,
no. Girl, you are for that. Swing my way. You think us full of lies.
Yeah. Golf win, golf shit, man. Shout out Jacquees. Switch it up. Pick my car up in an hour. This view is beautiful. Yeah.
Unless you get them pipes like Whitney Houston or Mariah Carey, you suck at karaoke. And people only watch to make fun of you. So, why not add a little bit of kick for more fun? Here's a spicy karaoke segment from Kyle Williams.
Can we just like flop them around and go?
Sexy gay.
So I'm so scared.
Pick the other.
What if I have an anxiety attack on camera?
I don't want to laugh for there is
just one thing I need.
I don't care about the presents. Oh, I feel that.
Underneath the Christmas tree.
Why you for my own? More than you could ever know.
Make my wish come true.
I'm so scared.
She coughing.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Christmas. Christmas! I feel like I'm gonna crush this. Alright, this pepper. Alright, man.
See no,
you. Not taste good. I don't want a lot for Christmas.
There is just one thing I need.
And I don't care about the presents.
Underneath the Christmas tree.
I don't need to hang my stocking.
There upon the fireplace.
Oh, I just want you for my own.
I'm
a bomb. Make my wish come true.
Give me a bag. I want more.
bonus Hanukkah round.
And when it's dry and ready, oh dreidel, I will play.
Dreidel, 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 we've made it.
And when it's dry and ready, oh dreidel, we will play.
Is that the answer?
I didn't sign a lease.
How do you feel?
My nose is running. My tongue's burning.
It's done.
Oh my God.
Before we close, we would like to thank Beacon for giving us this special platform to showcase our talents on Broward Teen News.
If you liked what you saw and would like to see more, check out our Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube for more, all at McFatter TV.
Also, a special thanks to everyone at the CCNN Live and John A. Ferguson teams for being a part of our show.
And thank you so much for watching. Reporting for McFatter TV, I'm Max.
And I'm Mariah.
Broward Teen News was brought to you by ProSound and Video.